بسم الله الرحمن الرحیم، لا حول ولا قوة الا بالله العلی العظیم، الحمد لله رب العالمین، وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا ابي القاسم المصطفى محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين، لا سيما بقية الله في الأرضين، أجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف. اللهم أخرجني من ظلمات الوهم وأكرمني بنور الفهم. اللهم افتح علينا أبواب رحمتك وانشر علينا خزائن علومك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. الحمد لله، we have توفيق to have our study of أوصاف الأشراف by the late Khaja Nasiruddin Tusi resumed. This is very important text in practical spirituality. And as you remember, we said we are studying first in the book Bidayat. Bidayat are those things which are for the beginning of the journey, spiritual journey of wayfaring, and they are six: Iman, or faith, which we already alhamdulillah discussed; Thabat, steadfastness, persistence; third, Niyya, intention; four, Sidq, honesty, truthfulness; five, Inaba, returning and repentance; and six, Ikhlas, purification, especially purification of actions, intentions, etc. So when it comes to the second, the beginning is always, of course, an ayah. Every chapter starts with an ayah, which has direct relation to the topic or is closely connected. He quotes ayah number 27 of Surat Ibrahim, Allah Nabiyyana wa Alihi wa alayhi salam. يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that those who believe with a firm word, Allah is going also to keep them firm, to keep them strong. If you take the first step firmly with determination and then ask God, you know, please help me with the rest of my journey, God is going to help you, but you have to try your best and then he will help you. In dunya, when we have lots of challenges for faith, and sometimes, you know, people lose their faith very quickly, as I maybe said, you know, before, that in some hadith about Akhiru Zaman says that sometimes a person yusbihu mu'minan wa yumsi kafiran. In the beginning of the day, he was mu'min or she was mu'min, but then loses faith over a day. Or sometimes, yumsi mu'minan wa yusbihu kafiran. It starts the night with iman, but overnight loses iman. So in Akhiru Zaman, one of the things that we have been warned about is loss of iman. Those who don't believe from beginning, it's another issue. But we as believers also should not think that we are going to remain necessarily as believers unless we prepare ourselves for challenges and try to be persistent. So if you believe with unchanging, unwavering word, a firm word, then Allah is going to make tathbeet. Allah is going to keep you firm, strong, well-rooted, well-established in dunya and akhirah. Even, inshallah, you can become a pillar for protecting others. Not only your iman will be, inshallah, saved, even you can help other people to protect, save their faith. And fil akhirah also. Okay, now let us see what's the main discussion in this fast, in this chapter. Of course, it's very brief, it's just a page. Even if we say a page, means like just an A5 page, not an A4 page. He says, Thabat, which is the title of this chapter, is a condition. It's halati, is a condition. That unless it comes with iman, it's accompanying iman, we cannot achieve tranquility. If you want tuma'nina for your nafs, you want to have nafs mutma'inna, if you need tranquility for your nafs, you don't want to be shaken by challenges, by positive things. Sometimes we are challenged, sometimes by negative things. Sometimes when I am very good, you know, in my, I don't know, study, in my, I don't know, voice, in my, I don't know, physical appearance, these positive things make me lose my tranquility and I try to do something maybe wrong. Sometimes negative things can make me lose my tranquility. So, tranquility is very important, serenity is very important. And without you have thabat, iman is not going to produce tuma'nina. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. There are lots of discussions about these beautiful words of Quran. I'm not now going to talk about dhikr as a way to reach tuma'nina. But I'm saying when Allah says, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, those who have iman and their hearts are tranquil with remembrance of God, it doesn't mean a loose iman, a shallow iman that can, you know, disappear. It has to be deep and deep-rooted, deeply rooted. So, he says, if sabat, if persistence, steadfastness doesn't accompany iman, tranquility of soul does not happen. And tranquility of the soul is a condition for searching for perfection. A spiritual journey is a search for perfection. And you need tranquility, because if you are not sure, you are undecided, you are always in doubt, then you cannot get anywhere. I always, you know, refer to the issue of determination in aqaid when we talk about the prophets, and also in akhlaq, when we talk about some of the important things in the spiritual journey and in ethical life, we talk about azm. Azm means determination, persistence, istiqama. It's very much needed. Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam says, علمت أن أفضل زاد الراحل إليك عزم إرادة يختارك ذات. The best provision of the wayfarer is to have a strong determination by which he chooses to over anything else. Determination is very important. Or Quran says, الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكه ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. Those who say our Lord is God and then they remain steadfast and persistent, angels and the spirit come down to them and give them bishara. So we very much need this kind of persistence. He says, if someone is mutazalzil, is, you know, in a very shaking position with respect to his or her faith, cannot look for perfection. Persistence or steadfastness in Iman means to be sure, to be certain that there is perfection and absolutely perfect being, the most perfect being. You must know that this exists. And therefore, you try to move towards that most perfect and gain more perfection for yourself. If this determination for search for or seeking perfection and this steadfastness in determination don't come, سلوک ممکن نباشد. It's impossible to have a meaningful spiritual journey. You're not talking about few days or few hours, you know. You're talking about a meaningful, a reasonable, considerable experience of a spiritual journey. It needs persistence. Because it's not something that is a matter of few minutes. Also, he refers to the Ayah 71 of Surah Al-An'am. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the people who have no firmness, their example is like someone whose aql is stolen or robbed by shaitan, and they are hayran, they are confused, they are perplexed. They don't know where to go. Therefore, I read the whole ayah, or at least the remaining of ayah, because this is the middle of ayah. Ayah is ayah 71 of Surah Al-An'am. It starts with قُلْ أَنَّدْعُ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَنْفَعُنَا وَلَا يَذُرُّنَا till it reaches كَالَّذِ اسْتَحْوَتْهُ الشَّيْطَانِ فِي الْأَرْضِ حَيْرَانِ لَهُ أَصْحَابٌ يَدْعُونَهُ إِلَى الْهُدَى اَعْتَنَا, which becomes إِلَى الْهُدَى اَعْتَنَا. These people who are confused, whose aql is robbed by shaitan, they have companions who are good people also. Among friends, they have good friends as well. يَدْعُونَهُ إِلَى الْهُدَى, they call him towards guidance. Maybe a classmate, a roommate, a colleague, neighbor, relative. اعتنا, come with us. Come to, you know, it's a very, very nice invitation. They call them to our souls, but say, اعتنا, come to us. We want to go together. But if Shaitan has taken you're up and you are confused, what can you do? Cannot make any progress. The one who is confused is not determined. The one who is perplexed is not determined. He says, تا جازم یک جهت معین نشود حرکت و سیر و سلوک از او واقع نگردد. Unless the wayfarer becomes certain and is determined to go the right direction, no journey happens. I should know what's my direction and don't let anything to carry me away, to deviate, etc. To go backward, to choose another You have to find your way and then continue. If you make supposedly a journey, even for some time, but you have not achieved that yaqeen which is coming as a sign of thabat and steadfastness, this journey, this movement that you made is not considered as a big thing. It is istirabi wa taraddudi bi hasil. Yeah, you have just had a kind of hesitation, and with that hesitation which has no fruit, you made some movement, it's not going to produce any fruit. If you don't know what you are doing or why you are doing, or if you are weak in your intention, then you don't gain that much. How can I have thabat? We said Allah, of course, is going to help you, but how can I qualify myself by having at least a little offer that, you know, I have tried to be persistent, please help me more. He says, you need to have basirat batin be haqiqat mu'taqad khish, number one, va vijdan lazzat isabat va malake shudan an halat batin. So if you want to reach sabat, you need basira, you need insight to go to the underlying layers of the realities and, you know, incidents, events, whatever. You have to go deeper many times to make sense of what is happening on the surface. You need to know the roots, even, you know, in politics, in economics, in many things, in even psychology, psychotherapy. If you don't know the roots and you just want to deal with the symptoms and on the surface, you may not solve the problem. So you need to go to the roots. These roots are not somewhere that you can dig physically. It's not like the roots of the tree, say, okay, let me remove the soil and I find the roots. These roots need to be discovered with basira, with insight. And that is a great gift of Allah, if you can go lower, you penetrate the surface and see things as they really are. So if you have this basirat al-batin about the reality of your beliefs, if you have gone deeper into understanding Tawheed, Nubuwwah, Ma'ad, etc., this deep understanding and this deep welcoming these facts help with persistence. Plus, finding the pleasure, experiencing, enjoying the pleasure of hitting the truth, reaching the truth, and then trying to make it a malak, a permanent quality of the soul. And then one of the consequences would be that righteous deeds would be done by ashab an thabat da'im wa zaruri, the people who have that persistence all the time. If you have persistence, inshallah, you will succeed. Persistence in learning, persistence in practicing, persistence in salah, persistence in charity work, persistence in community work. Anything good, anything positive, don't do it once or twice. Or once you do a lot, then you don't do anything, and then you start again and do it. No. Be committed, be persistent, steadfast, so that these things become part of you, become a kind of your nature, second nature. So this is Sabbat. Let me introduce also the next topic. Chapter 3 is about Niyyah. قال الله تعالى قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. Interestingly, this ayah is also in Surah Al-An'am, like the ayah كَالَّذِ اسْتَحْوَتْهُ الشَّيْطَانُ فِي الْأَرْضِ حَيْرَانُ. This ayah is also in Surah Al-An'am, and it is verse 162, and the translation is as follows: tell truly my prayer, my nusuk. Nusuk means acts of worship, or some people said my devotion, so that devotional works. My prayer, my worship, my life, my death, all belong to God, the Lord of the universes or intelligent inhabitants of the world, depending on how we translate Al-Alami. So my salat is lillah, my nusuk are lillah, my mahya lillah, mamat lillah. Means everything that is related to us and is in our hand, it is voluntary, should be dedicated to God. Otherwise we are not going to benefit, especially when it comes to ibadah. How can ibadah, which is not dedicated to God, can help us? Actually, if it would not only not help us, if it's not dedicated, it would even cause lots of problems. Then after that, Khaja says, what is niyyah? You say intention. What is niyyah? Niyyah is a kind of qasd, is a kind of intention, kind of seeking a purpose. And this intention is in between knowledge and action. You need to have knowledge to make good decisions and then good intentions. Without, you know, having knowledge, you don't make good intentions. For example, if they don't know there is such a book, you don't make niyyah of reading it. If you don't know there is such a course, you don't make niyyah of attending. But also, it's followed by action. So knowledge, niyyah, and then amal. Of course, niyyah is very important part of amal. And niyyatu asasul amal is the foundation and the basis of action. So niyyah is a middle term, middle fact between ilm and amal. If you don't know, if you don't have ilm and knowledge, you don't know what you should, you know, be persistent about and what you should be sincere about. So you need knowledge. If you don't have niyyah, you become like a robot. Or if you have bad niyyah, certainly it's going to not help you and even harm you. When you do something with wrong niyyah for showing off, it becomes even worse. But it should also be followed by actions. Actions are fruits plus they feed. Imagine a tree that is also benefiting from its fruits. Inshallah, we are going to have very good discussion, inshallah, not very detailed, but inshallah, good discussion about niyyah and sincerity. We discuss in the Akhlaq series of the Hawza in London, also in the first year, the issue of niyyah in more than one session. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us sincere and dedicated and persistent, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Is there any question?
You're also welcome to type them up and we can read them out for you if you don't feel comfortable calling on tonight. Assalamu alaikum, Shaykh.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
My question is, we are in this very special days of when Prophet Musa went up to the mountains.
Yes.
How can we, give us some practical tools that we can bring together these three elements, sincerity, dedication, and persistence in these very, very special days? Give us some practical tools, inshallah.
Yeah, this is a very good question. It's a session, but briefly, if you want to be inspired by what happened to Prophet Musa, we should know that Prophet Musa had different encounters with God. The very first one was without appointment. The one that is explained in Surah Taha, for example, when he saw fire and he says to his family, فَقَالَ لِأَحْلِهِمْ كُثُوا أَنِّي آنَسْتُ نَارًا. And then he went, and then Allah for the first time talked to him. This was without appointment, but for sure this was not by chance. Musa was a person who had such a life that now Allah chooses him as his messenger. But then later he had also sometimes appointments, especially when he wanted to receive the tablets, al-alwah. Musa, who is already a prophet of God, spoken by God, had to do something special. For 30 days he had to prepare. He had to be in presence of God, but very much focused and concentrated. وَوَاعَدْنَا مُوسَى ثَلَاثِينَ لَيْلَةً. So the appointment was for 30 days, but it was not sufficient. وَأَتْمَنَّاهَا بِعَشْرٍ. Then we completed it with 10. So if there were only 30, was not complete. 40 is the sign of completion. So, inshallah, all of us should try to have pious life throughout our adult life, at least. But also, we need to have times that, like Musa alayhi salam, we have more contemplation, more tawajjuh, more attention. And this is very productive if it can be continued for 40 days, then another time, another 40 days. This is what we call chelle neshini. So if possible, maybe you cannot, of course, totally isolate yourself, but at least for 40 days, for example, from beginning of month of Dhul-Qa'dah up to the 10th of Dhul-Hajj, these 40 days that for the Prophet Musa were very productive, and then he finally received the Torah. Maybe we can also sometimes choose 40 days like this and be more careful about our words, about our actions, about our planning. Spend more time on dhikr, on Quran, on salat, on charity. These, inshallah, then blocks of spiritual, you know, days, and weeks, little by little, can bless your entire life, inshallah. So what I want to suggest in answer to your question is that now that we are in these 40 days which a prophet of God was asked to observe, we should try, inshallah, to increase, even if it is 10%, your devotional work. And this doesn't necessarily mean to do more things. Maybe you can do more thinking, more contemplation, more self-assessment, and maybe more about that. But something non-stop should happen. Something with persistence should happen. And you know that if you do something for 40 days, inshallah, it is strong enough to remain, not to evaporate or, you know, die out.
Jazakallah.
May Allah bless you, inshallah. Maybe we can end with Dua Faraj, inshallah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد اللهم كل وليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك توعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا رمنا علينا برضاه وهب لنا رأفته ورحمته ودعاه وخيره اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم ارحم موتانا اللهم اغفر لوالدينا ولوالدي والدينا ولمن وجب له حق علينا ولمن أوصانا بالدعاء ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. May Allah inshallah bless you and iltimas a dua.
Thank you so much. Thank you,
Shah.
May Allah bless you.